everybody. This is Grace Machado, future biologist and hopefully also future herpetologist. So today we're actually going to be feeding Lightning. That is the name that we currently have for him. It may or may not change, but I think this one might stick. And I'm just going to be showing off what an amazing feeding response is and also talk a little bit about the way that they eat and brush over a little bit on the setup that I have for their quarantine bins right now and why quarantine is so important and what I do for mine and what other people can also do for their kinds of quarantines. All right, so this is Lightning's quarantine bin setup. He's going to be here for at least 1 month. Need to get the camera to focus. There we go. At least 1 month, although I'm going to try to get it closer to 2 or 3, and that he's just going to stay here. I don't know why my camera is having such a hard time focusing today. But anyways, this is just a very small enclosure. It looks really, really awesome. I've got some water here. I actually need to put some new water in here as well. I'll go ahead and change that. You don't need to see that though. We're just going to go ahead and feed him. I'm just moving some stuff out of the way because I believe he is hiding. He does have an amazing feeding response, so I'm not too worried. As you can see, he's already perked up, excited, ready to eat. And I'm just going to be feeding him a small pinky. Right now I'm just feeding him a small pinky every 3 days just to make sure that he's got a good feeding response. I want to make sure while he's in quarantine that he has healthy behavioral that he has healthy behavior, that he's eating correctly, that he has a nice feeding response. And I'm just going to throw this in here, and he's going to just get a whiff of it in a bit. It's been defrosting for a bit, and as you can see, he has an amazing feeding response. He has a very aggressive strike, and he's always a side eater, which is great. Let me move that over here where there's some less bedding. There we go. Oh, let go. There we go. So he has an amazing feeding response. Now, just a little bit about his enclosure. I do have a lot of aspen. Usually when doing quarantine, you want to make sure to use paper towel. However, I have had a lot more success just watching them, making sure that they're not, that they're not eating their bedding while eating. And I do have a lot more success just putting a lot of aspen because as they are a burrowing species, they really, really do benefit from having a nice solid like inch or two of aspen, occasionally even more, and they will burrow down to the bottom so that they can feel safe and secure, and you just have to drag that all over the aspen, don't you, Lightning? So he is actually a very interesting feeder in that usually hognoses will try to adjust to the side and they'll try to get their meal either through the butt, which is, seems like what he's going for, or by the head, but I've actually had him take a meal and just eat it completely sideways. It was very gross to watch. I'm not going to go too much into detail. But yeah, so usually for my quarantine bins, I want to give them a small enough bin. There's a rule of thumb that as long as a snake can stretch out completely along the sides, they are okay. And hognoses also do have a tendency to benefit from smaller enclosures a lot more than bigger enclosures, as big enclosures make them feel very nervous and insecure. He is not eating bedding, by the way. It might look like it. He's just rubbing it all over. Here, let me actually move this aside a little bit. Oh, you're fine. Let me just grab that for you. There you go. So it's actually very important that you give them a small enclosure to begin with, especially during quarantine. This isn't usually what they're going to stay in their whole lives. I wouldn't recommend keeping an adult hognose in a tiny bin like this, unless they are in quarantine, because having smaller enclosures does actually give you a better chance to feeding. He really wants to just shove his head in there. It's a lot better for them to have a better feeding response, and it will make it easier for you to transition them into their future enclosure, just making sure that they are actually able to eat, that they have good feeding responses, that there aren't any health issues. It also makes it easier for you to monitor and clean up. Quarantine is also very important for new reptiles that you are bringing into your collection. So you want to be able to make sure that they don't have any mites any other health issues before introducing them to the rest of your collection. You are a nightmare today. You know that? Here, let me. Nope. Okay, he doesn't want to share. There we go. Don't want to stress him out too much. Oh, thank you. Oh God. Okay then. He got a little sassy. He's not too happy with me. Okay, so he's gonna go and eat in the corner now. But again, I have been feeding him a few times already since we've gotten him, so he's a pretty good feeder. I'm not worried about him not eating the pinky. I just want to make sure he doesn't get any bedding, and it looks like I got all of that out of the way. Sometimes it's actually very helpful to get a little plate. Sometimes you can use the enclosure and just have it as essentially flip a hide upside down, and you can put the meal there, have them eat it there so that they don't get enough bedding. I do just want to make sure that they're eating consistently before I start messing with them too much. And that is one of the benefits of using paper towel during quarantine. It's not going to be sticking to the food and all of that, so you don't have to worry about the stress. It does look like he decided to eat the pinky butt first. He's enjoying himself. He is a very, very amazing feeder. He has an amazing feeding response. But again, so for the quarantine bin, which is what I was trying to mention, I have a nice little setup. I've got two thermometers. I've got a thermometer here from ZooMed. And I also have a ZooMed, the hygrometer thermometer combo. And I have the thermometer hygrometer combo over there in the back. I just have a few holes drilled in by the sides so that I can put in the probes. It is not big enough. I even use a little suction cup to actually cover the hole. And he is nice and satisfied. He's finishing up his meal. And then I have the heating pad over there in the back. Excuse my finger. And I just have half of the enclosure. I have the little monitors over there, the probes monitoring the back temperature to make sure it doesn't get too hot. I have the thermostat hooked up over there as well. And then over here in the front, I've got the cold end being monitored to make sure it doesn't get too cold for him. I'm trying to decide if he's actually going to look for more food or if he's going to just bury himself. Because he seems to always be hungry, which is not, I haven't seen that a lot with hog noses. But yeah, so this is what I have for him. I'm going to go ahead and just change his water, readjust his hides and all of that, make sure he feels nice and comfy so that he can go and digest. Looks like that's what he wants to do right now. He's just going to go see, bury himself, and just call it a good day. All right, well, thank you so much for watching, and good luck with your quarantine.